Let our hearts say amen.
Amen.
Let us say amen.
Amen.
We're in the midst of a good time this morning.
Yes.
We just want to give all the praises to the Almighty God.
Yes.
That we are back in the house of the Lord one more time. Those of you who have your Bible on the back of the morning time, thank God for my wife and my family being with me this morning. Thank God for my son Carmichael. He's coming out of school this year. And he got a birthday on next Friday. As you get out the door, just wish him happy birthday. Amen. Amen. You may turn with me to Daniel, the second chapter. Daniel, the second chapter. We'll read from the 17th to the 23rd verse. And then we're going to take it back up at the 27th and 28th verse. Amen?
Amen.
If you got it, say amen.
Amen.
And it read out, "Then Daniel went to his house and made the thing known to Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, his companion, that they would desire mercy of God of heaven concerning this city, and Daniel and his fellows should not perish with the rest of the wise men of Babylon. Then was the secret revealed to Daniel in a night vision, and Daniel blessed the God of heaven. Daniel answered and said, 'Blessed be the name of God forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his. And he changed the time and the season. He removed kings and set us up kings. He gives wisdom unto wise and knowledge to them that know understand. He revealed the deep and secret things. He knows what is in darkness, and the light dwelleth with him. I thank thee and praise thee, O thou God, O my Father, who has given me wisdom and might, and has made known unto me now what we desire of thee. For thou hast now made known unto us the king matter.'" 27 and 28 verse. "Daniel answered in the presence of the king and said, 'The secret which the king had demanded cannot the wise man, the astrologer, the magician, the soothsayer show unto the king, for there is a God in heaven that reveals secret and make known to the king Nebuchadnezzar what shall be in the latter days. Thou dream and vision of their head upon their bed are these.'" Amen. God bless the reading of the word. You may be seated. We gonna talk to you about when the bottom falls out. When the bottom falls out. Look at somebody next to you and say, "Your bottom will fall out." Amen. Bobby here, eternal God, I thank you for your word, and I thank you for your presence right now, Father. As I step out of my shoes and you step in, Father, oh Father, let your people feel your Holy Spirit. Rain down in this place, oh God. Build them up while they are torn down, Father God. Heal right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God. I pray. Amen.
Amen.
The other matter for us to understand what God is revealing in chapter 2. We're going to have to go back to chapter 1. All right. Among those who were chosen for some from Judah, Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, chief officers, gave them new names. Daniel, the name Belshazzar. To Hananiah, Shephariah, to Mishael, Meshach, and Azariah, Abednego. But Daniel, he resolved not to defile himself with the raw food and wine. And he asked the chief officer for the permission not to defile himself.
Yes, sir.
Now, Fenella had invited Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and meet at his table. And the chief officer served them vegetable and water.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Daniel was a wise man. Now God had caused the officer to show favor and compassion to Daniel. But the officer told Daniel, "I am afraid of my Lord, the king who had assigned no food and drink.
Yes, sir.
Why should he see you looking once again the other young man your age? The king will then have my head because of you."
Yes, sir.
Daniel then said to the guard whom the chief officer had appointed over Daniel, Hananiah and Mishael and Azariah, "Please test your servant for 10 days. Give us nothing but vegetable to eat and water to drink." So he agreed to this and test him for 10 days. After the 10 days, they look healthier and better than any young man in battle.
All right.
The guard took away their chosen food and the wine that they was to drink and give that vegetable instead. To these four young men, God gave them knowledge and understanding. King found them to be 10 times better and wilder than any physician or astrologer, soothsayer in his kingdom.
All right.
Here's the story of chapter 2. Nebuchadnezzar had a dream. Astrologer, the Chesedine, and the musician all standing before him. And he asked him what was the meaning of his dream. He asked him to interpret his dream. And the astrologer, the Chesedine, and the musician, and all them that stood before him said, "King, how can we tell you the meaning of the dream when you have not told us what the dream was?" So King Nebuchadnezzar said, "You mean to tell me that I got to tell you what the dream is all about?" He said, "I can't tell you what I dream, I want you to tell me what I dream. If you are wiser and you are astrologers and you are musicians, you ought to be able to tell me and interpretate my dream.
All right,
God. The astrologer and the musician and all of them said, no man can tell you or interpretate your dream unless you tell us what you dream. So the astrologer and the musician and all of them standing before him, standing closer. King Nabuchodonosor said to them, said, well, what is a man for? Said, you all up on me, close to me, and you cannot tell me or interpretate my dream. So the king now with the man signed a decree.
Yes,
and given it to the chief officer who served Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in Daniel, vegetable and water at the table. Sign a decree, and he taken it to Daniel. Oh, Daniel, that since you 10 times wilder than your astrologer and the musician and all of them, along with them, all of y'all, should be put to death. This is where the bottom fall out. Here, Daniel had been, he had been elevated to prime minister and prestige. And here is he going to be put to death along with the astrologer and the magician. Amen. And he was wiser than all of them there in King Nabuchodonosor's battle.
Yes, sir.
So we look here in our text. It doesn't matter about the bottom falling out. You got to hold on to Jesus. Here you have been on your job 35 years and the bottom falls out. You get a piece of being laid off. Here you have been healthy as a bull and goes to the doctor the first time and come back with a test and said that you got cancer. Here you have been working for 40 years and you finally retire. And you come home and you find out you got to raise your grandchildren. The bottom has fallen out. Don't think that you are so holy and that you are Christian and that you are saved that the bottom won't fall out. Because from this pulpit all the way back to the city, one day, if it ain't fall out now, keep living. The bottom is going to fall out. We're living in a world where we need the Lord on our side. Daniel and his companion have went through many things in their life. They had been robbed of their background, their history.
Yes, sir.
And their name had been changed.
Yes, sir.
King had ordered that this wise man not only interpret his dream, but also tell what the dream was.
Yes. Mercy.
So Daniel, he praised God.
Yes.
Who had saved his life. God does still speak to us today.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes we may not even realize it's God speaking.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
But make no mistake, God is still very much alive.
Yeah.
And sometimes God even let us know when it's done. Like being let in on a fantastic city.
Yes, sir.
So we live in a world where we got to pray at all times.
Yes, sir.
Y'all yes, sir. Praying for me.
Uh-huh.
Yes,
sir. So we got to rely that it makes no difference how you live here on this earth.
Uh-huh.
One of these days, the storm of life gonna be raining.
Yes,
and then you know, sometimes I think about the song said, all of my good days outweigh my bad days.
Yeah.
I won't complain.
Yeah.
But you know, in this life, being on the human side, sometimes we get it gets so rough, we start complaining. And sometimes we realize that the Lord won't put no more on us than we can bear. Sometimes we look back and we ask the Lord, Lord, why me? But we get to realize that one day Jesus was here on this earth. And he healed the leprosy on me. He healed the sick and raised up the dead. He gave sight to the blind. And one night he went to a wedding and turned the water into wine. But one day the bottle fell out. Yeah, you know, back in the olden days, the lamb was killed by the sinner.
Yes.
And the sinner man would take the lamb to the tabernacle.
Yes,
and slaughter the lamb and take the blood and give it to the priest.
Right.
And the priest was sprinkled around the altar for forgiveness for their sins.
Yes,
but I'm glad that Jesus got up one day and saw our enemy.
Yes.
That we don't have to kill a lamb or bull anymore.
Yes.
Oh, Lord. But we can go to Jesus because he got up and gave his life for all our sins. All along, the bottom fell out when Adam and Eve committed sin. But Jesus said to his father, Father, give me a baby boy. All along, and I'll go down and redeem man. And Jesus went out there out on Calvary Hill. Hear my Lord and your Lord with a judgment hall to judgment hall. They placed and Mother Mary standing at the cross. The tears streaming down in Mother
Mary.
Look at Jesus hanging there on the cross. Yeah, I can hear him say, Father, why have you forsaken me? Yeah, but he's looking at the bottom of the line. Yeah, he looked down and saw all our sin. God good, it won't fall out anyway. Amen. It just only a test. You just got to keep the faith and believe in Him and stand on His word. Amen. Stand on His word, believe in Him, and keep your eyes on Jesus. Amen. Faith without work is dead. Faith is the something of things hope for. Ever is a thing not seen. See, you just can't see faith, but you got to have faith. Amen. When the bottom fall out. Amen. We'll sing a little bit of this song. We'll turn it in the hand of the pastor. See what the Lord has done. You ought to look around and see what the Lord has done for you. See what the Lord has done. See what the Lord has done. You ought to count your being blessed and see what the Lord has done. See what the Lord has done. See what the
see what the Lord